So a hot topic in tattooing today is the potential regulation of the industry by the federal government. With nearly half the millennial population being tattooed, the FDA sees it as their responsibility to protect public health. But is there a way that the industry can self-regulate? To answer this question, maybe we could look to other industries who face the same problem. For instance, the automobile industry preemptively took on child safety. In fact, the UFC is trying to get in front of the medical problem of CTE to avoid regulation as we speak. So how could the tattoo industry follow their lead? Well, we'd first have to clearly define the problems that we're trying to solve. We partnered with S8 Tattoo to take some deeper dives into all aspects of tattooing. So as a tattooer, I tend to think, you know, my clients rarely have problems. My tattoos heal up fine. Do we even need regulation at all? If it ain't broke, don't fix it. The problem with that line of thought is that I am taking from a very small sample set, just my own tattoos and the tattoos of my friends and colleagues. The federal government, on the other hand, is looking for large health trends.
Now that such a large number of people have tattoos, there's things that most folks wouldn't think about. So if you have all of these people that have tattoos and there's something that you introduce at the regulatory level that might interact with that poses a health threat, you would want to know that way in advance.
And with more and more people being tattooed, they see a potential for greater risk. So we talked earlier about the main ingredients in tattoo ink. Well, which of those ingredients is the FDA actually interested in?
There's things that most folks wouldn't think about that I think they are interested in. And so they're looking at epidemiological things. And that means that you look at all the vectors of threat. So it could be everything that you threw down the sink to how those tattoos might interact with high-frequency radiation. So that's why they want to know what specifically the pigments are made out of. What happens if all of a sudden down the road someone needs to have triple bypass surgery and he's got a big chest piece? What kind of risk could that pose to peripheral blood that they would gather up and retransfuse that person with? Do they have to consider that? Is there something that the radiologist might know of, the cardiologist might know of, with different therapies that they put that person on, different drugs that help their recovery? Is there a contraindication with that particular compound? If it's a metallic salt, it's possible that it could interact with it. If you knew in advance that that was a problem, then you could take action so that you didn't have that. The tattoo industry, unfortunately, is not forthcoming with all of these building blocks. One of the things that might be holding them back is people might feel that that's unique intellectual property. But that kind of, in a way, to me, doesn't make sense because the company has lots of other things they can compete on. How well that ink flows, for instance, the density of the ink. There's a number of performance factors, and then there's the color palette itself.
Going forward with Fireside, I would like to dive a little deeper with ink technology. In future episodes, we'll discuss other uses such as beef grading, counterfeit detection, computer vision and augmented reality, and even finding cancer cells. That's it for this episode. We'll catch you next time.
I want to give a special shout out to this video's sponsor, S8 Tattoo. You can check out all of their fantastic tattoo products through the link in the description below. Use the code FIRESIDE to get 10% off of any tattoo product. Thanks again for watching, everyone. Be sure to check out our website at firesidetattoo.com for tons more content, including our weekly video podcast, our Fireside Technique series, courses, workshops with top tattooers and painters, and also unique Fireside merchandise. And be sure to subscribe for more exciting content coming soon. We'll catch you in the next video.